A movie critic writes about the movie First Man, which is coming very soon to our theater in February 2019, as follows. First Man uses a personal focus to fuel a look back at a pivotal moment in human history and takes audiences on a soaring dramatic journey along the way. Neil Armstrong himself stated in October 1999, however, like this, though he mentioned nothing about the Apollo 11 mission. We have no proof, but if we extrapolate based on the best information we have available to us, we have to come to the conclusion that other life probably exists out there and perhaps in many places. What is, then, the Apollo 11 mission for human beings? 2019年の2月に First Man という映画が封切られます。ニール・アームストロング個人の伝記のような映画だそうですけども、大変楽しみにしています。で、そのニール・アームストロングは1999年10月に次のような証言をしています。証拠はありませんが、私たちが入手可能な最高の情報による推測によれば、次のような結論に達しています。つまり、他の知的生命体がそこかしこ多くの場所に存在していますと。あのアポロ11号ミッションは人間のために何であったのか、もう一度考えてみたいと思います。広志林浜松セリージャパン。私の動画の中で繰り返し取り上げてきましたアポロ11号ミッション、そしてその謎ですが、私が得た結論は次のようなものです。確かにアポロ11号ミッションは存在した。そして3人の宇宙飛行士が月に向かった。2人の宇宙飛行士が月面に降り立った。これは事実のようですが、同時に万が一の場合に備えて別のところで、つまりスタジオでアポロ11号の偽ミッションが作られていたということですね。ここで言う万が一というのは、つまりアポロ11号ミッションに何らかの不都合な事実、あるいは事態が起きた場合ということになりますが、その中の一つがアポロ11号の乗組員たちが月面に降り立った時に、つまりその周囲にエイリアンのクラフトがたくさん現れる場合も想定していたそうです。スティーブン・ M ・グリアー博士は辞書Unacknowledged の中でそのように書いていますが、実際そのような場面にどうやら遭遇したようです。そこでスタジオ撮影されていた別の、映画をですね、捏造映画を随所に挿入して、その場面を言うなればごまかしたということになります。 Mission Control. What's there? Mission Control calling Apollo 11. Apollo 11. These babies are huge, sir. Enormous. Oh God, you wouldn't believe it. I'm telling you, there are other spacecraft out there. Line up on the far side of the crater edge. They are on the moon watching us.
Mission Control, what's there? Mission Control calling Apollo 11. Apollo 11, these babies are huge, sir, enormous. Oh, God, you wouldn't believe it. I'm telling you there are other spacecraft out there, lined up on the far side of the crater edge. They're on the moon watching us. Here you can see a picture of
Mission Control Center. 何があるんだって?こちらミッションコントロールセンターアポロ11号どうぞ。アポロ11号、これらのベイビーは大きいです、巨大です。おお神よ、あなたは私を信じないでしょう。私は今こうして話しているのです。そこに他の宇宙船があるのです。それらがクレーターの反対側の端に並んでそこにあるのです。月の底にあって私たちをウォッチングしているのです。広瀬林、浜祭りジャパン。
As a teenager, Tompkins had an eye for detail and loved to create Navy ship and submarine models.
これがニール・アームストロングが1969年7月に書き残したスケッチ画と言われているものです。本物か偽物かということを議論する前に、真実の追求者というのは常に一部 あるいは1尾の嘘もあってはならないと心がけているものです。1尾あるいは1部の嘘でもあると全てが否定されてしまうからです。つまり All or nothing、 本物か偽物かということになりますと、私は本物であると判断しました。こうしたスペースクラフトがですね、クレーターの反対側のエッジにずらりと並んでいたというわけです。謎に満ちたアポロ11号ミッション、その向こうには何があるのか、調べれば調べるほど謎が深まるのがアポロ11号ミッションということになります。One of the world's leading UFO researchers who has lectured. 私林博が今まで調べてきたアポロ11号ミッションの結論はこうです。アポロ11号ミッションは確かになされた。その結果3人の宇宙飛行士が月面に到着した。これはもう事実だと思いますが、同時にニューヨークのスタジオで偽のアポロ11号ミッションの着陸の様子が捏造された。理由はいろいろ考えられますが、スティーブン・グリア博士の本によればですね、万が一宇宙飛行士たちが月面でエイリアンたちに遭遇した場合に備えて、そのような偽動画を用意した、つまり動画って言いますかね、画像を差し替える、入れ替えるためにそのような偽動画を作ったというわけです。が実際にアポロ11号の乗組員たちはですね、月面にエイリアンクラフト、あるいは ET のクラフトを見てしまった、あるいは見せられてしまったというわけです。そこで急遽偽画像に差し替えられ、世界中に報道されたということです。以上が私林博が現在のところ得ている結論ということになります。 A photograph of Apollo 11 on the moon shows no trace of jet or injection of jet on the ground under the lunar module Eagle, as has been pointed out by BBC UK. But here I, Hiroshi Hayashi, have found another unbelievable mystery in one of the astronauts' helmets. On July the 20th, 1969, Apollo 11 was a space flight that landed the first two humans on the moon, Mission Commander Neil Armstrong and pilot Buzz Aldrin were the two. Armstrong became the first to step onto the lunar surface 6 hours after landing on July the 21st. アポロ11号の着陸船イーグルの下にはあるはずのジェット噴射による噴射痕が残っていません。英国の BBC 放送がそれを指摘しています。上と下を見比べてみてください。人というのは自分の常識にあまりにもこだわるあまり、そこにある矛盾を見落としてしまうということがよくあります。太陽の光線を受けると物は影を作ります。そしてその影は見方によっては平行にはなりません。そのことをよく知っています。が、この影はどうなのでしょうか。右にある人の影とその左にあるポールの影がこのままでは途中で交差してしまうことになります。影というのは無限大の一点に集中するわけですけども、この影もやはり途中で交差するかのように見えます。この影にしてもそうです。つまり光源体は一点ではなくて二点あるということになるのではないでしょうか。さらにこの影は、左の影は前から後ろへ、そして右の影は右から左へと走っているのがわかります。注意深くご覧ください。これに対して、魚眼レンズを使ったからこのようになったというふうに説明してくださる方がいらっしゃいました。が、本当にそうでしょうか。いくら魚眼レンズでも90度に交わる影などというものがあるのでしょうか。もう一度影を並べてご覧ください。左は自然光による影です。右はアポロ11号が撮ってきた写真の影です。影が途中で交差するのがわかります。左の写真はですね、自然光ですから、いくら遠方行っても2つの影が交差するなどということはありえません。繰り返しになりますが、こういうところからもですね、右のアポロ11号の写真はですね、少なくとも2点以上の光源があるということになるのではないでしょうか。さらに、さらに奇妙なことが続きます。自然光による影はですね、見る角度位置によっては平行に見えないときはあります。これがその一例ですが、しかし決して交わるということはありません。で、もう一度先ほどの写真を見直してみました。まあ、このように影がですね、このまま先に行けば途中で交差してしまうということになります。無限大の遠方ではなくて途中で交差してしまうということになります。まあ、この影もそのようではないかと思いますけども、はっきりしません。がしかし、まあ自然光による影ではないように見えます。この影もそうですというふうに考えていたのですけども、ここで奇妙なことに私は気がつきました。もう一度この左の人物と石の右のですね、右上の 石の影を見比べてみてください。まさしく直角に交わるかのように見えます。この宇宙飛行士の影も奇妙といえば奇妙です。ライトは頭のですね、左右についています。ここが重要ですから覚えておいてください。ライトは頭の左右についています。となりますとですね、この影を作った光源はどこにあるかということになるわけです。中心部が明るくて周りが暗いです。つまりこの影はこの宇宙飛行士を真後ろから映した光による影ということになります。となると影の矛盾は消えるということになりますが、では左の宇宙飛行士をこのように後ろから映している光はどこから来ているかということになります。もちろんヘルメットの左右についているライトからでないことは確かです。ヘルメットの左右についているライトではこのような影はできません。と同時にこの周辺だけが奇妙に明るく、そしてその外側は奇妙に暗いというのも大変気に入られます。まあアポロ11号の撮ってきた写真にはですね、このような奇妙な影があちこちに映り込んでいるということです。イコール怪しいということになるのではないでしょうか。それとも魚眼レンズ説をあなたは信じますか。当時魚眼レンズはできたばかりでまだ一般にも普及していませんでした。 Bye for now。
1969, the world watches as astronauts take their first steps on the moon.
That's one small step for man.
But the race wasn't only in space. The moon landings provided the US with a priceless piece of propaganda against the Russians. In fact, some people think that it was so valuable that they would have done anything to achieve it, even if it meant having to fake it.Winning the space race was a massive victory for America, but some claim it was a Cold War con trick filmed on Earth. Former professional photographer Marcus Allen says these pictures look too good to be true.
So in the photos themselves, are there any clues that things aren't what they seem to be?
Definitely. Let's have a look at this sequence of photographs here. Taking the detail of Aldrin's right heel,You have the highlight of light on the heel. Where did that come from? A highlight is produced by a point source of light. But the sun is directly behind the lander. So this whole image here is in shadow. It is not illuminated by the sun. No additional lights were carried on Apollo 11. There are no reflectors except the lunar surface. This photograph, I contend, was taken under controlled studio lighting conditions.Here's a picture showing an astronaut taking the photograph and his shadow, which indicates that the sunlight, the only source of light on the moon, is directly behind him. But then you look at this rock just off to his right, and the shadow is at right angles to the astronaut's shadow. That can't be right.
Okay, but when you look at the footage, there's no way that can be fake. Look at this. This kind of floaty movement, how did they achieve that?
Well, very straightforward. You'd film it at normal speed and then slow it down.
Now, of course, the consensus is that our giant leap wasn't filmed on Earth.
But if you were going to try and do it, how easy would it be? Here is Luke, a researcher, all right? Not so much an astronaut as a paid next to naught. Now, here is a piece of wire attached to two very big blokes. Yeah, all right. So what we do next is we pick Luke up...And then we slow him down. Okay, Luke, visor down, please. Don't forget you're on the moon. Action. Bearing in mind it's his first go, that was awful. We need to take more weight off. Try and keep your hands in front of you, a bit like ski poles, because that's what they do on the NASA stuff. Action.
Okay, yeah.
Now we're getting there.
Yeah, we're getting there.
Best one yet. What we should really do is slow it down.
Okay. Yeah.
And then see if it's any more convincing.
Yeah.
Because at the moment, I'm kind of with NASA. That's quite good.
Perfect with the loom and the rover and you and the old flag. Come on out here and give me a big navy salute.
Slowing it down does make a big difference. It's got that kind of spacey feel about it. That is quite good. I could possibly watch that and maybe think that it looked like the one I've seen before from NASA. Of course, NASA denies the conspiracy theories, and scientists say there's rock-solid evidence that man went to the moon.
We have 400 kilograms of rocks brought back by the Apollo astronauts. They've been analysed by scientists all over the world, and no one has been able to say that these rocks come from the Earth.
One of the things is that the shadows on a lot of the still photographs don't seem to go in the same direction.
But actually, it's very hard to get a sense of distance when you're looking at these lunar pictures. And if things are much further away, it will appear that the shadows aren't parallel. So actually, what we're seeing on the moon is the same as we see on the Earth, and it's just coming down to perspective.
Whatever happened 40 years ago, our fascination with the moon isn't over. China's said to be planning a moonwalk by 2024. And then we will know what's been going on, because, of course, when they get there, they'll find all the flags and all the other stuff that the Americans left behind, won't they?
My conclusion is this. We were tricked by the US government in 1969. Here I can show you some of the evidence. 1969年、私たちはアメリカ合衆国政府に騙されたのです。その証拠を皆さんにお見せします。It is a very sad and a shocking news. 1999年3月7日、あの2001年宇宙の旅を監督したスタンレー・キューブリックがこの世を去りました。そのこの世を去る3日前、スタンレー・キューブリックがこう告白していました。1969年の月面着陸はすべてインチキだった。私がその映像を作った本人だと。その3日後、スタンレー・キューブリックはこの世を去りました。そのインタビューをそのままここに載せます。その動画はスタンレー・キューブリックの遺言に従い、16年後の2016年1月1日に公開されました。広し林Hamama City, Japan.
The moon landing hoax?
That's right. That the moon landing was fake. The moon landings all were fake. And I was the person who filmed it.
You're serious? And, okay.
I'm serious. I'm dead serious.
Because I only...
1969年7月16日にですね、ニール・アームストロング船長、バズ・オルドリン、月着陸船操縦士、マイケル・コリンズ、司令船操縦士の3宇宙飛行士がですね、サタン5型ロケットで月に向かいました。そして3日半後にですね、月周回軌道に到達。それでまあ7月20日にですね、司令船コロンビアから分離された月着陸船イーグルはですね、火炭ロケットの噴射で減速しながら、月面、静かの海に軟着陸。アームストロングとオルドリンが人類として初めて月面に降り立ったと。まあ、そういうことなんですね。で、この飛行で
まあ、アメリカ合衆国は、亡きケネディ大統領がですね、上下両院合同会議における演説で表明した、1950年代の終わりまでに人類を月面に到達させ、かつ安全に地球に帰還させるという、まあ、施政方針に応える形で、これを見事に実現させたのであるということになっていますけども、それらすべての話はすべてでっち上げの嘘だったということになります。が、謎が残らないわけではありませんね。となると静かの海に現在残るですね、アポロ11号の発射台や、その時添え付けたという反射板などは何かということになりますね。まあ、それについても、スタンレー・キューブリック氏はですね、アメリカ政府は詐欺に詐欺を重ねたと告白しています。まあ、それは全てをですね、その映像を作ったスタンレー・キューブリック氏が、この世を去る3日前に、まあ、画像としてそれを残したというわけです。で、これからそのインタビューの内容を報告しますが、インタビューのですね、ウェブサイトに文章としてその時の内容がですね、書き起こされて紹介されていましたので、インタビュアーの T. パトリック・ムレー氏に敬意を表し、それをそのまま翻訳させていただきました。音声と翻訳文が前後入れ替わり、一致していない部分があるのはそのためです。どうかあらかじめご承知おきください。
Coming out or
no?
Okay.
It's not about any movie. It's not about the movies I've made in the past. It's a confession of sorts.
Okay. I mean, about you cheat on your wife. You plagiarize.
I would never do that. No.
Plagiarize something.
It's about a movie I made that nobody is aware of, even though they've seen it.
Okay.
Are you drinking? Do I have you a drink?
Well, I mean, see if I understand what you said. It's about a movie you made, no one knows you made. Is that what you said?
That's right. It's a production.
Like, so you put, like, you didn't put your name on, like, at the end, you put, like, a fake name?
Oh, no, I made it.
Like, Alan Smithy, like, that's
right. No, I didn't, there was no name put on it.
Why? Why would there be no credits? What do you mean?
Because there are some things that you just can't put your name on.
Okay.
I perpetrated a huge fraud, which I am now about to detail.
Okay.
Involving the United States government and NASA.
All right.
And I'm sure you've heard the rumors.
The moon landing hoax?
That's right. That the moon landing was fake. The moon landings all were fake. And I was the person who filmed it.
You're serious, and okay.
I'm serious. I'm dead serious.
Because I only have this certain amount of time with you, and I'll talk about whatever you want. You know, this isn't some type of joke or
no, it's not
film
a joke.
Within a film thing.
No joke. Nope.
Okay.
The conspiracy theorists were right on this occasion.
Why?
I don't know about Paul McCartney's death, but this they were right about.
Okay, why in God's name? I don't know what to ask you first. Why the hell, if you're telling the truth, why would you do it? Why are you telling me? I mean, what the...
Don't you think it's important for people to know the truth?
Yeah, I got. Yes, certainly.
They had a massive fraud, an unparalleled fraud perpetrated against them. They should know.
Okay.
They're already suspicious of the government. They may as well have their suspicions confirmed.
Okay.
And justified.
And this, why now? I mean, we're almost at the 30-year anniversary. What took so long? Why, if this is true, why?
I won't go into that. It has to do with personal.
Okay.
Of evolution and influences.
And, well,
I'll go into that.
Is that why you look a little haggard right now? Because you look a little worn, no offense. Like,
well, also, yeah, because I haven't been taking care of myself too well. I've been drinking a lot, but...
Is that because of the stress of this?
Of course. Stress, guilt, just conflict of all kinds.
Wow, I mean, so you feel bad about this, clearly. I mean, this is...
I do feel bad about it. I also feel proud of it. It's a terrible conflict.
Because you've pulled off one of the greatest hoaxes ever because of
your... And because I made a film, if you want to call it a film, which I consider to be my masterpiece.
And you can't take credit or even talk about it as a... As
well,
a
you are now. I'm hereby taking credit.
Right, but you can't actually go out. You're doing... When people see this, no, it'll be, you'll be dead.
Until 10 years.
Right, or 15, yeah. My death. So you can't talk to Roger Ebert about it, you know. Does that frustrate you?
I have to pay the consequences for the decision that I made many years ago to go along with this.
Like a deal with the devil.
It's Faustian, to be sure.
Because, and is that why you got such power in Hollywood? I mean, that would explain that.
Why I have the freedom I have, that was part of it, yes.
So they said, do this moon thing and we'll give you...
When I made Spartacus, I didn't have this kind of freedom.
Right.
But I have it now.
So what came first, the genius or the fraud?
NASA's doing.
What came first, the genius or the fraud? I mean, did the fraud enable the genius, or was the genius released by the fraud?
I think the genius came first.
Right.
But some frauds are hard to bypass, especially if you have an ego, and you're an artist, and you're presented with a challenge, the likes of which you've never seen, and will probably never see again. You don't even think of the morality of it. You're just completely swept away by the flattery of it and the juices inside you, which make you want to do it as the artist you are innately. You don't think of anything else.
What a conflict. I mean, gosh, I can't imagine being presented with that opportunity. On one hand, I really would want to do it, but then I'd probably say, well, I'm committing a crime and... lying and...
It depends, but my guess would be, no, you if you're good, you would do it. I discussed this with Levinson, Barry Levinson.
Right.
I discussed it with...
Oh, you mean by the dog, right? Yeah.
Yes. Spielberg, of all people, believe it or not, yes.
So wait, why the dog?
Coppola, Scorsese, even Woody Allen, I discussed. There isn't one of them who wouldn't do this.
Right. And did that, so Barry Levinson must have been influenced by this whole, he must have known, so that's, Wag the Dog is about this whole idea. Oh, I mean, that's why...
The character was named Stanley.
Right, and he gets killed at the end because he demands credit. Coming out, or...?
No.
Okay.
It's not about any movie. It's not about the movies I've made in the past. It's a confession of sorts.
Okay. I mean, about you cheated on your wife, you plagiarized...
I would never do that, no.
Plagiarized something.
It's about a movie I made that nobody is aware of, even though they've seen it.
Okay.
Is that intriguing? Do I have you intrigued?
Well, I mean, see if I understand what you said. It's about... A movie you made, no one knows you made. Is that what you said?
That's right. It's a production.
Like, so you put, like, you didn't put your name on? Like, at the end, you put, like, a fake name?
Oh, no, I made it.
Like, Alan Smithy, like that?
That's right. No, I didn't. There was no name put on it.
Why? Why would there be no credits? What do you mean?
Because there are some things that you just can't put your name on.
Okay.
I perpetrated a huge fraud, which I am now about to detail.
Okay.
Involving the United States government and NASA.
All right.
And I'm sure you've heard the rumors.
The moon landing hoax?
That's right. That the moon landing was fake. The moon landings all were fake. And I was the person who filmed it.
You're serious, and... Okay.
I'm serious, I'm dead serious.
Because I only have this certain amount of time with you, and I'll talk about whatever you want. You know, this isn't some type of joke or...
No, it's not.
Film within a film thing.
No joke. Nope.
Okay.
The conspiracy theorists were right on this occasion.
Why?
I don't know about Paul McCartney's death, but this they were right about.
Okay, why in God's name would... I don't know what to ask you first. Why the hell... if you're telling the truth, why would you do it? Why are you telling me? I mean, what the...
Don't you think it's important for people to know the truth?
Yeah, I got... Yes, certainly.
They had a massive fraud, an unparalleled fraud perpetrated against them. They should know.
Okay.
I mean, they're already suspicious of...